Here in Tijuana, the proposed new rule, which would prohibit people from applying for asylum if they traveled through a third country, underscores a harsh new reality that very few people, if any, are being allowed through the port of entry each day.
It's now been four consecutive days where no numbers have been called off the unofficial list on which asylum seekers wait for months for their chance to apply for asylum. Speaking to asylum seekers, most were unaware of the new rule set to take effect Tuesday. With no new numbers being called, many are feeling isolated and trapped in a country they don't feel safe in. Tony, an asylum seeker from Cameroon, didn't want to be videotaped. He told me applying for asylum in one of the countries he's traveled through to arrive in Mexico would be impossible due to the discrimination he's faced and the language barrier.
You can see that let us seek asylum just anywhere, just into any other country that we get into. What if that country is not as free as the United States? What if you have communication barrier, the language barrier?
At El Otro Lado, a legal nonprofit that works with asylum seekers in Tijuana, migrants continue to register for services as they arrived in the city. The flow of migrants into the city remains steady, but the demographics have changed. Right now, they estimate only 10% of asylum seekers registering every morning in Tijuana are from Central America. This means a policy that is aiming to deter asylum seekers from Central America would be applied uniformly to asylum seekers from all countries. Shane Mulligan works with asylum seekers at El Otro Lado.
So this policy is a part of an effort to just tighten the noose around forms of humanitarian relief for people from around the world, and seems to be specifically targeting people from Central America.
The Department of Homeland Security, in a joint statement with the Department of Justice, says the new policy will reduce the overwhelming burdens on our domestic system caused by asylum seekers failing to seek urgent protection in the first available country, economic migrants lacking a legitimate fear of persecution, and the transnational criminal organizations, traffickers, and smugglers exploiting our system for profits. San Diego immigration lawyer Andrew Nieter believes that the new rule will be swiftly struck down by the courts.
The current asylum process is based on not only international treaty, but U.S. laws that were passed by Congress and that have been in place for decades.
Regardless if the new rule goes into effect tomorrow or not, the status quo in Tijuana will possibly remain the same. Even as more and more people arrive, very few people are being let in. In Tijuana, I'm Max Rivlin-Nadler, KPBS News.